just from Kingi Taurua in Gisborne. Today, Thursday, the 16th of June. Good, Kingi.
Yeah.
Are you in Gisborne?
Yeah.
Oh, are you going around to see Sue? Oh, okay. No, that's all right. I just thought that, well, I got the that Mongol fellow went and told me. He just finished upsetting me. The Mongol. The bull-headed Mongol. Yeah. That's Hoheba. He's... Yeah, no, he hung up on me. I told him, keep it out of my business. Keep out, it's been too much. He stick to his own thing and leave me out. He's trying to control what I'm doing, and he's trying to muscle in on that Marae now. Too smart for that, for the Waitangi Marae. That's your business. Yeah. No, I'll do that. Then I'll do that if he keeps ringing me up when I told him I don't want anything to do with it. Now he's upset Willie Pater. He's upset Willie Pater on his marae now, because Willie rang me up last night, and then Hoepa got on and I says, "Oh, your mate just rang me up and told me what's going on," and I tore a strip out of him last night on the phone on Skype. I said, "What you've done to my mate Willie on his marae?" So that's it's caused a rift right through the whole bloody place, and he's trying to muscle in on what I've got online. When he went to have a look at my videos, he says, "Oh, I see that you've been saying a lot of things about what's going on in Napui." I said, "Yeah, but I've been around on the scene for a long time. However, this is Confederation's business, not what you are aligned to." The flag is not your business. You don't know what it means. And so you're better off to stay looking after the old people and leave this alone. So that's where we left it just now. And he just keeps thinking that I'm underneath him. I said, no, I'm with Kingi and Sue, and that's the end of that. So we keep on our track. We keep on our track, do your thing, keep on going until I come up with the goodies.
Okay.
Hey? He told me, he said, he asked you to go to their meeting and you said, "No, you're going on Gisborne." That's how I know. He said, you're not there with their meeting. The meeting they're having is totally different to what we're on here. Is you've got to stick with the government. And you can't veer off the track with the law. They're trying to break this law on their own. No, it don't work. I've been through all that lot. I don't waste time with it. I'm sticking with the law in the court. And that's the way we're going to go through court. We're going to go through the right way. And as long as... I'll send Desmond there to pick you up, to take you to see him and then return you. What's the name? I'll bring her there. Whakatoa Marae Manatuke. Well, what I'll do is I'll get Desmond to bring her out there. Is that alright? Yeah, I'll get him now to pick her up and come out there. You there all day? Afternoon?
Yeah.
Okay, what time about?
Oh,
okay, well... Okay, so you'll be at the Marae in the afternoon, eh? And
yeah.
I'll just get Desmond to pick her up and bring her to see you.
Yeah.
Because she's waiting for Hirschfield to come down and sign the papers. We're getting close to getting things going with her.
Okay?
Okay. Okay, right. Yeah, that's Kingi Taurua, the chief. He's in Gisborne. Now he's going to go and see... Get Sue to go and see him. I'm getting a bit hoo-ha with what's happening up north. The Confederation is one thing. The Taumata is another. The Confederation flag is a global matter of commercial trade, banking, and normal business. I didn't want that to get mixed up with anything else in that marae in Waitangi. The Waitangi Marae is specifically business. It's the New Zealand government and our business with the hapu and the Confederation of Chiefs. That's totally different. Those people know who they are. Colt Gregory and a few others. Alf Mitchell. These guys are in that group with me pushing that agenda. And Georgie Job and Sue Nikora and all those who know they're in that field, the other ones that are flying the flag religiously all these years, over 20 years now, they're flying the flag. I'm letting this notice out to you because Ohepa rang me up, or Epiha, he's looking after the Taumata in Ngā Puhi. I suggest they look after the old people and the elders in their part of the department of the upper house, in that Te Ti Marae. Stay there, because the other marae is totally business. It's totally business and New Zealand's interests at heart and at law. So we've got law on one side, tikanga on the other side. The law, L-A-W, is what I deal with. The L-O-R-E is what you deal with. However, I must say, because I'm getting upset with hearing that the Confederation, by the looks of it, is getting sidelined. Nuki Orich, if you're watching this video, you should know how that works, because we've been together for years and years, pushing that agenda. You know the correct process with this flag. It's your flag, Ngā Puhi. I'm here for you. I just talked to Kingi because I'm keeping on track with him, because he's the last man on his feet on that marae at Te Ti, and on the other side now in Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. King William IV flag and his ship beside the marae is the picture I'm painting, brand new, here today from the old days when that first went there. Okay, so I'm joining up the history of that. That's an area where I suggest anybody that has nothing to do with it stay right out, because it's at war at the present time. This flag is at war with Obama, the Queen, and the Rothschild banks. It's very serious, however. This is very serious. I'm making a statement here that do not anybody interfere, tamper with any of the documents we got online, because they're being watched by the British military, the British government, and United States interests, and Trump for that matter. We're supporting him getting in just because he's a businessman, to run it on the right trail. If you're not in business, it's very difficult to try and convey this to the Taumata, because more than likely they have never, ever been in business And I've been in self-employed business over 20 years now. So I know what I'm doing with business and real estate and land and native law. And British law for that matter. So I'm going to ring Sue Nikora now to get Desmond to go around, pick her up and take her down to see Kingi on the Marae. And get on with it. Time's running out, people. Time's running out. I'm telling you right now, the 16th of July, 2016, this year, next month, is when the New World Order law kicks in. If you didn't see that coming, I'm sorry, it's too late for you. I've been documenting this Lisbon Treaty since 2008, when the racket started, this racket that's going on now, with Obama and the Queen, and Admiralty court-martial law of this flag that Obama's using to kill people in America with the Muslims. Okay, it's out of control. And it's our business to straighten it with this flag, with the British military. You're watching this video, the British military, you're obligated to the native of New Zealand and Pacific Islands with this flag and King William IV to recover all the debts that I've just put those pound notes and the gold coins of King William's online beside the Queen's gold coins. That's for you to investigate and arrest those concerned that are violating the interests of the public for their own interests. Private interests, I must say. I'm ringing Sue Nikora now. Kia ora. It's John Wanoi here, the sheriff. Look, I'm going to get Desmond to pick you up to... I'm going to get Desmond to pick you up to take you out to see Kingi at the Marae, Manatuke. Manatuke, this afternoon. He's having meetings at the moment, but to go and see him. Manatuke. Whakato Marae. To meet him. To go and talk. To go and talk. Go and have a talk. Oh, they're doing some business with the Maori Battalion. The war people. The war veterans and that sort of thing. He's there with the Maori Battalion. He's there with the Maori Battalion. I'll get him to... Well, he's going to somewhere at the moment, Kingi, but it'll be after lunch. After lunch, not now, because they're in meetings and they're going somewhere. And then they return to the Marae, probably just after lunch. Be about after lunch, after midday. And you can take your stuff and go and have a little talk with them. Because he's in tune with me and you, and that's the and Marae up north. That whole heifer got on my nerves this morning, just now, and upset me. Okay, all right. Yeah, that's Sue Nikora. Okay, I'm just saying. I'm putting the foot down now as the sheriff, the King's Bench Court sheriff on Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. Hohepa. I'm there because I've been appointed from the 3 years in a row to go to Westminster from the Taumata and the Elders in Te Ti Marae. And I made it specific to go and seize that Marae on the other side. That's an idea that came out of my head. Not for anybody's business to inquire into private business. And that's what Admiralty is, private business. If you go and tamper with it, you'll get strung with the law if you start tampering with that. Now, I got no issues with you and what you do on the Marae with the Elders. But anyone cross my path with the Confederation and this flag who doesn't know anything about it is going in a serious side of the law, especially when this is a war flag. It's a declaration of war flag. And the churches have turned everything upside down with the Pope saying that the Catholic Church doesn't believe in God and Christ anymore, and Bible. That's the problem with the Catholic Church now. You've got a problem. With the English Church of England, they've got a problem too. The churches are fighting and the place is in a mess. And the Taumata is not in that field. They're spiritual, so go and look after the home fires and the marae and leave the war to us, the rangatahi. But they are trying to find their way after all these years. And Patariki, to you, if you're watching this video, you follow us on the right trail with your incorporations to make business work. It's a long trail to try and match this and commerce around the world. You have to sell yourself. If you can't, you stay in one place in that area and can't get around the country. Sui's going around the country. She's already set it up. Going around and doing it twice. It's no time left to go and run over tracks that have been covered. That's what I'm saying about Georgie Job. She's there with Sue. They know what they're doing. Straight to the UN, straight to World Court, straight to Westminster, straight to Switzerland. That's where we're going. We're not waiting around. We shouldn't be here. We shouldn't be here arguing about going around collecting people up. You should have known that. Everybody knows that. If you've been in the Confederation, there's no need to go and do things twice. That's not the Moai way. Once finished, done. All the talk should have been done on the marais, and because of that, you have to go around and collect them all up again. It's very difficult just getting past Tainui with this kaupapa, because they've got their own flag. They've got their own flag. They have a right to their own flag. I'm not putting their flag down. I'm just saying they have a right to Britain and their hapū. You can't mix iwi with hapū. It's one or the other. This is hapū. This is not iwi. This is hapū. If the hapū, if the iwi on that Waitangi Marae is playing around with this hapū flag, they're in trouble. Because they haven't got no consent from the chiefs. And the chief I'm talking to is Kingi Taurua, because he's the last man on his feet, the oldest on that marae, on that little piece of land. At Te Ti Marae, that little piece of land, and the other Waitangi Marae land, that's his, as far as I'm concerned. I just needed one chief to take the whole title. Okay? And when you look at all the other people affiliated to this flag, that came later. That's not a contract. A contract is signed once. You don't go around a year later picking up signatures. No, that's illegal. Everything else attached to that is illegal. The only legal part of this is the 1834 Navy that came into Russell, Kororareka, first mortgage, second mortgage on Waitangi land block at Waitangi Marae, where the treaty grounds are, right? So it's been fabricated around in the Crown's paddock. As such, it's just an occupation title. It is not clear title. They haven't bought this country out yet. Not likely to either, as far as I'm concerned, over my dead body. So I just ring my nephew to pick Sue up and take her to meet Kingi to update our United Nations trip, World Court trip to Geneva, and Brussels, and then to Switzerland, and then to Westminster, and then back here. That's all set to go in 2012. We're still here, still trying to rake some money up. As far as the Cook Street's concerned, that's attached to that marae now, the King's Bench Court on that Waitangi Marae, inside that marae. I have access to go in there anytime I want for that reason. Of history, of the Moai statue, the Tahitian Moai statue that belongs to the Hapū natives of this country. Now they realize that those iwis that are operating that marae in their business, it's business versus business. one business is taking more interest than the other business. In this case, the hapu's business is not even off the ground yet, and the iwi's business is taking all the benefit for its private contract self. John Key's company, Waitangi National Trust, is just another private company. See, it's not even limited. It belongs to him and his private elite clubhouse and courts. Now that's what I've got issues with now, transferring the court case that I have on Cook Street through the Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, highest authority of this flag of Admiralty, which is mortgage. Admiralty's mortgage bank, the pound notes. Those pound notes come under this flag, as was 1838 and 37, still is it now in 2016. All we had to do is sack the partner we got the Queen and get a new one. We have King Ernest Augustus V living in London. He's the rightful, legitimate King of Britain, UK, right, and Hanover. He's the legitimate king behind his ancestor, King William IV, and Ernest Augustus I. And back to William the Conqueror, and back to the Normans, King Solomon, and the Danish King Solomon. So I'm saying there's a long line trail of the king's mine and gold trail right through to this flag, right through the years, 1480, straight through to 2016, still there in contract, unbroken continuity of sovereignty to us and the British people. So I'm thankful that the elections in Britain looks certain to be a Brexit exit from the EU Parliament that was set up by Gordon Brown, Scottish man, and Queen Elizabeth behind closed doors. I was right in the middle of that, documenting it all the way through in affidavits. It's fixed. I've fixed her before, during, and after the crimes she did with Gordon Brown. Now I see Gordon Brown trip-trapping back to Britain. He wants to be in the Brexit group. Well, that's fine. That's fine. But not forgiven. But fine, as far as I'm concerned. Because he had a rope around his neck then. He's still got a rope around his neck now. Because you can't trust anyone. At least Nicola Sturgeon is straight up. She says she's going to stay in EU. I see now that Sinn Féin, Northern Ireland Republic, wants to come back to Britain. Good. That's my bloodline. Sinn Féin, if you're watching this video, and you be Irish people, Northern Ireland, Ulster and Munster, you're our DNA family of Cosgraves, and on Jamie's Patrick side, the Patrick family, and also the Scottish Stuart family. So we've got those with us to come there to Ireland and Scotland, and go to England with that amount behind this flag and the pound note, levy debtor instrument, to recover everything. We are expecting and have the British military and the government, the new British government, to salvage all of that stolen property back into the King's Bench Court in the Rolls Building in London, forthwith. Okay, so I'm acting surrogate king's sheriff to confiscate property here on 77 Cook Street, Auckland, and the Waitangi Treaty Grounds, and property on the East Coast. For starters, it will be 77 Cook Street, straight off. From this video to Shannon Withers, from Vulcan Chambers, lawyers, my lawyers and barristers, this is a message to you. I'm talking to Tu Nikora, the future Prime Minister of New Zealand, native government, and Kingi Taurua, the chief of that Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court. I have full authority from the Chief and the Prime Minister of that government to do what I'm doing. To go to England, Westminster, and to take this flag and stick it up where I wanted Matt Taylor to do it in England. And he did such a good job, but I have to do it as a native to come there and put it up on King William's estate land in Devon, Port Plymouth, first before going to Westminster. I'm going to pay my homage and respects to the King. I swear my oath to King William IV and his ancestors back to King Solomon and William the Conqueror, who gracefully put England together and salvaged everything to make it what it is now, today. That was history I've just looked over, and before I go there, prepare myself and Jamie to come there for good reason, to re-establish, reassert our King's Bench Court authority with the British, our partner, and the military, our partners. That means that the British military won't be taken away to EU Parliament Germans for their own private interests under Admiralty law, I must say. So the Admiralty remains with us here in the Pacific, and America for that matter, if Trump gets in. We're hoping that he will be the Prime Minister to replace Obama, the terrorist. I'm naming you on this video, Obama. You're the terrorist that's caused Orlando's shootings, and it's all fake, all set up, Hollywood more than anything, to make money out of. You are behind bringing all those Muslims into the country with the Queen. I'm holding the Queen liable for all of this, and she's got that green debtor's note on her head. I've got a pound note there, the green one with Jamie and I on it, and that is levy debtor against all of your interests, your property and your inheritance back to the King. I'm talking for the King, King William, King of England, King of Scotland, Ireland, and Hanover, New Zealand, Pacific Islands. So, one more time. To the Taumata on Waitangi. You should know me by now, been there over 20 years, going there all the time, and saying the same tune. I haven't changed one bit, still the same, only more polished these days, up to date with what's happening around the world, not just up the road. Sue Nikora's already been around the North and the South Island. All she's got that budget put together, and I got them to talk over that with Kingi today, since he's in Gisborne, with the battalion, Maori battalion, meetings. And that's got a lot to do with this flag too. It's a war flag. He's a war man. He's been to Vietnam War, so he knows what he's talking about. And that's all that matters. We're in a war zone at the present time. If Obama comes here with the Navy in November, there's a war going to be happening here. The same. You'll be chipped. You'll be held up. And if necessary, locked up. If you start going against their law. We have our law, it's the law of King William IV. Higher law of Admiralty, court martial law. We can use it on them because we have authority. The Pope demolished their use of that law. The UCC law, the Admiralty law of the sea and of the land, the canon law, courier law, and civil law, and trusts and corporations, the Pope demolished. He destroyed the whole lot, and he's bringing his new law out and new religion, other than Catholic law, out on the 16th of July this year, next month. So I can see, by looking at our own people here, have never grasped that fact. They've never watched the world news on exactly what is going on in churches who run the parliaments. The Vatican runs the parliaments here and the universities. They have the money, the most money, to do what they want with guns, they have the biggest army, 193 countries in the Vatican's army, signed up in the United Nations. That's why we're going there. I'm going there to tell Hirschfeld, our lawyer, barrister, he's ready to go. We've set this up long ago, and soon Nikora, to go to the United Nations to tell them a thing or two of this flag. Once this flag goes up there, it takes precedent over the Admiralty law, and the British has to be there too. So, one more time. I get onto Cook Street, I bring the British judge into the District Court in Auckland, and he'll take over confiscating anything that's been stolen or fraudulently acquired. That's the elite side. This is a warning to you that this is the most powerful flag in the world. The King William 1835 Declaration of Independence war flag. It is a state of emergency flag. Once this flag goes up, it sets the area as out of bounds. And this country be out of bounds. It'll have this flag flying as a state of emergency right around till we change the government. John Key, you've got to go. You've done enough damage. You've made our image here not trustworthy. The same as Obama. Not worth trusting. All right? And there's good reason for it. We're going to investigate all your businesses. I'm ordering the British military judges to come here this time and investigate all the Commonwealth countries' businesses with this flag. We have the authority, Mr. John Key. It was just not told, and no one knew what to do with it. Okay, I'm here to do all of that. I've had long enough to learn all your tricks, and the end is nigh. So to the people in Ireland, we're coming there, Jamie and I, and we're going to link us back to the Normans, Danish, my friend in Tauranga, doing the hydrogen projects on the Moai tidal turbines, Kevin Reyes, he's Danish Viking, that's the Viking, he's got a very strong voice, and he's my right-hand man in business. He will be constructing everything on computer and the designs and everything we do here at the East Coast when he took it out. We already set that up. So I'm just saying, on the economic side of Moai, King William Trust, this flag has set our businesses right up around the world, not just on the Marae up in Waitangi, around the world. That's our Marae. It's around the world where the Moai stands. Every country that's more powerful has got a Moai standing in it, an original one. That's our title, DNA. Okay, John Key, that's our title, and this is our other title, King William. What have you got? An absent queen, eh, of fraudulent coronation. There's enough information to sink the whole lot of you. Put you on a ship, next container ship out of here. And anyone, even the IWI trusts, you're going to be investigated where all that money went to. Right? We're going to investigate every business, every title of land, every person in this country. Right? There'll be plenty of work for sheriffs. I can say that much. If you think you can do the job, you don't need half a brain to do it. All you have to do is just go and ask them, can I check your title and you? Right, with those 8-point star badge, 8-point star, 8-point four corners of the earth, and the sea, blue, and the red, King George, Pope Francis, Catholic Church, red. That part of King William, because he loved popes, that part is joined to Ireland. The Pope took the 8-point St. Patrick's Church, that's Jamie. St. Patrick's name, the name Patrick is on this flag as the New World Order. So we are confiscating that 8-point star back into England, soil land where it was put together in the first place. Pope, it's not your title. It belongs to the Irish and the English and the Scottish and the Welsh, old people. Welsh and England, old England. I know now a bit about them because they know all about us. We're only here for making hakas and putting a carpet for the Queen to walk on and walk straight past us. Not anymore. We're going to walk over her head when we get there. Right? She's had a 90th birthday, but little do you know, underneath that hat of hers, there's something going on. Just like what Trump said, there's something going on. We are there to find what it is. I can tell you everything about what's in her head. Okay, so I think that's enough for now. I just want to get on the phone and call Desmond. I might as well do it while I'm here, just to let you see that I ring real people that matter to me and the business that we're doing. I've got to find... Oh, Desmond, he's working at the moment, I think. No, we'll better find out. Bear with me. Bear with me. Here goes. This is my nephew. Doing an excellent job. I'm supposed to be at the gym, but Hoepa squatted me, and that flipped me out. Desmond, Uncle here. Can you give me a call, or Skype, or Facebook? Desmond, can you give me a call or text me or Skype or Facebook? I want you to pick Sue up after lunch and take her out to Whakatau Marae in Manatuke to meet Kingi, okay? But I'll try and ring you later. I'm supposed to be at the gym right now, but I'll just hang off a bit more and go later. So if you can do that or ring me first, let me know, okay? I'll try again later. Bye. He's a good man. He's been stuck with me all this time. He spent most of his time and years down in Dunedin, so he knows the South Island very well. And he'll be going down there, and he's got a lot of friends down there to help him to carry on with the business from that marae, Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, down there and take a piece of my brain with him because he's picking up fairly quickly and Jamie is as well. So those two are crucial to what I do. There are other people who have been with me on the way and I'll acknowledge them as soon as I get things sorted on Cook Street. I'm going to confiscate Cook Street. You people in there, you did wrong on what you did, and you're now third party with Natalie Flower Dew Brown, CIB detective, fraudster. I'm calling her a fraudster. She has to counterclaim what I'm accusing her of now in the Auckland District Court, and that's going to be hard for her to do. The police got a problem. That's why it's taken a long time for me to get my court hearing in there. And already my barrister says, there's nothing to stop me from going to Westminster. It's like saying, oh, you can go while we tear this place apart in New Zealand while you're gone. No, I'm staying here till I get Cook Street off, back into the hapu. Okay, there's fraud going on in there. The Panama tax havens are all through the businesses. And I've did enough investigation to prove that. It's up to you, John Key, to prove me wrong. You're going to find it very difficult against this flag, with your flag, that you want to throw away and get a fern flag. You failed on that. You'll fail on everything else, because this government you got was set up to fail Maori all the way along, because Maori is your invention. Iwi is your invention. It is your trust corporation's invention names. There's no such thing as Maori in 1840, 1835. You wrote it that way. You wouldn't find any words in the Maori Land Court records at 1840 that says Maori. It's always native. And with the British titles, there's no such word as Maori in it. That was put together and fabricated to make it your tribe. That's why you've got the birth certificates and bonds on the stock market. You gambled them and gambled everybody in this country, including the Maori natives inside that Maori government. Te Ture Whenua 1993 Act. You put all those things together so that you can take the land, because you can do what you like with Maori. Okay, that's why Moai's here. He's the original memorial, statue, head of this country. He's standing there in Auckland Museum. That's the title, John Key. That's the title to this Auckland. And the other Moai up north, there's Moai up there, and Moai down Dunedin. Those are the Moais that were put there. They were put there by the Queen. Okay? The one in Wellington on Island Bay, that's come from Chile with Helen Clark. They got that one replica made to claim the title to Canterbury, the Bishop of Canterbury, to take that title to the seabed with that Moai statue. That's a replica. That's not the real one. The real one is on Auckland Museum. The head part chopped off, and the Moai in Dunedin with the hat on his head, the crown. See, the Pākehā put it down there with the crown on the head. That's the real crown. That's the Moai crown, the hat on his head, the basket of knowledge that the Queen took that and put it there in 1933. That's when she became Queen in 1952. 1933 is when the America became bankrupt. You see, they took the first Maori off East Island, 1868. Took the first Maori statue off East Island, took it to London. That one in London is our title, John Key. That's my title. That's my own Wānoa title to East Island, Tahiti, and Raiatea Island and New Zealand Islands. Those all one title to the Pacific. Founding documents, doctrines of discovery title, John Key. And this flag is a doctrines of discovery title. This flag is a statement of confidence in what I say, do, write, and display in front of the world, our witnesses, Mr. John Key. It's all on Facebook. There's nothing for the judge and the court to say against anything I say, because no one's refuting any of it. There are statements, allegations, and accusations against anybody, including you. It's up to you to deny it and to counterclaim. You must counterclaim what I've already put up against you all these years. You have never said a word. It's Kingi's view to put this flag up on the flag staff on that marae, Waitangi Marae, and take it over. We're taking the land, John Key, and you've got to get off. That's all there is to it. We're making orders to get you off that land, and goes back to the Apu. As for the Taumata, they have to sit there and wait for me to come back to the Taumata to tell them what I've done and what I've been through in Westminster and here with Kingi. It's a military matter, Hohepa. This is a military matter. It's a life or death situation, and the Americans and their ISIS will blast anybody off this land if they get their foot in here. Now, the Taumata has no instruments or facilities, resources to stop them. They're going to come whether you like it or not. They're not worried about anybody's religion, tikanga, or anything. They'll come with guns boots and all. ISIS and Satan doesn't care. That's why the Catholic Church, I feel for them up north, because their leader, Pope, has demolished Christians out of their book and gone to the UFO. That's what your religion is now, UFOs and everything fiddly-piddly. That's all an illusion out there of things flying around. They're using money to make things fly around the place, to make it like it's real, like they've gone to Mars and back. And Moai is already on Maki Maki planet out there at the end of the universe. So that's all I want to say for now. I don't want to go into any more. Just to say that those people at Rangitukia, I just bought a drone to take aerial photographs of Rangitukia mouth, river mouth, to reclaim the land there and fix it up and give the crown and the iwi the bill. I'm going to give them the bill for all the 50 metres to 70 metres missing land off East Cape, because I know I measured it. I measured it off the maps of what's been eroded from Mount Hikarangi at the back of Sue Nikora's lands up the back of Hiruharama. She's the chief up there. She's the chief of that Hikarangi mountain. Okay? That's where she's talking from. So it's all that land that slipped into the sea because they chopped the logs down and took it to England. All those trees you fellas have got over there in Scotland and England, they've come from here, off the backs of Maori. And the legal nations, that's the last thing I want to say. The legal nations have set up from here, the Akaroa Bank, the native bank here in New Zealand, and then went to the BNZ Bank, and then went from there into the League of Nations, and from the League of Nations went to the World Bank, and then the United Nations. That was all constructed from here. Okay? I'm just saying in this way. And that's what I'm the trail I'm going down. Now, the Taumata can't do that. Whoever, they can't do that. I'm saying I'm commercial in my family, and I'm commercial in my profession, in real estate and land title issues. The land that everybody's occupying is a big thing, and the banks, a big thing to try and think you can do it if you haven't got that experience to talk like that. Okay? I've only known you for 2 years, that's since you've been on the Marae. I've been there over 20 years, however. I know everything about it. I know everybody that's concerned that are sitting on the buttons ready to go. I know who to call on. I know all those people that have been going there for years, including Paterika, that have been going there for years with Hohepa Mapiria and the incorporations. All of that is still the trust, with John Key corrupting the trusts. That's part of the trust, but the native have their own rights to administer their trusts. The biggest issue I have with that is there's a bigger beast than us fighting ourselves. There's a bigger beast out there. That's why I'm calling on the Irish and all those people in the New Britain to reconstruct, like what King William did. He reformed the Acts of Parliament. They have to reconstruct, and we're there to reconstruct with them the whole of the Pacific land back to Britain. And we have the titles here for the Pacific Islands and all of that expense to share it equally with the other countries on the shores of that Pacific Islands, all right, including America. But the elite want it for themselves. That's what I've got issues with. The private part of this flag of Admiralty is mortgage, lands, and banks, comes under this. No Pope, Church, or Queen can do this, only a king. The king put this together, back through all the kings, back to King Solomon. That's all I have to say. But back to my Rangitukia lot. I've got this drone coming, and it's going to have a fishing line with the bait on. Take the bait, and I'll see if it can carry it out and drop it in the water. I'm going to try it out. I'm going to do it on the land first, just in case it gets waterlogged and I can't swim out to get it. All right? I haven't got a fast one of those bike things in the water. jet ski to go and retrieve it. Anyway, that's my little subject when I go down with Jamie on the Mana bus down to Gisborne and meet up with Sue Nikora and Desmond and have our meeting there with the Tumutu Mupaidoa at the hotel there. And then go down the next day, the 28th, we've got a meeting in Gisborne with at the, I forgot what the hotel is now, but with the shareholders of Herenga A12. I'm looking forward to meeting you if you're watching this video, that I'll be there to have a little talk as far as the consultant of Tumutu Mupaeroa is concerned, accepted our invitation to go and listen to them. We're going to listen to them and they're going to listen to us. However minutes they're going to give me, I will tell them what I want to use that land block for and the funding that's coming, either from Sue or for myself. Then we go to Rangitukia here the next day on the 29th with Tamati Reid, and I'm hoping that Mana Oraro can come to the meeting, or anybody else around on the Haho 7B block can come to the meeting, I hope. But we will have a meeting with them another day as soon as I get light of sorting Cook Street out, and that'll set the whole world alight. One fraud equals the rest. That's the falling angel, falling card, right? House of cards, that's it there. The house of cards. The crown jewels is the Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. That's the crown jewels, that. And we just bang one peg out and the whole lot drops, right? It's all set up, and I just want the world to know. It's us. That's the missing link with the keys to Britain. Okay, welcome to our world. It's been sitting for 182 years, this flag has been fluttering around all the time, going up and down the street, protesting against the British. Well, now we're just as much British. And we're looking forward to coming to meet them, to do some business. It was set up for do business between us, the native, and you. We're still native, as ever. Might have changed our skin a little bit whiter, but that's fine. Okay, that's all I want to say. We'll catch you later. Today is Thursday, the 16th of June, 2016. And good luck to Trump and his birthday.